Yo, what is up? We're making our first vlog. There's the Evo. But yeah, we just got back from work. Just got confirmation that the wheels are here, so we're gonna take a look. Yep, let's see. Ooh, wheels are here. Don't mind the dirty garage. Okay, tires too. You already know. All right, y'all, this is the first unboxing that I'm gonna be doing. So you guys are gonna see what I see firsthand too. So let's dig right in. I'm excited. My first wheels I've ever got. Let's see what the hype is all about, right? All right. Here's the big moment. Ooh, I don't know if you guys can see that. It says Enki. Give you a better look. Let's see. All right. This is the what comes in the box. Enki, as you can see, owner's manual. These are one of my dream wheels, so hopefully you guys like them too, but this is what you see when you first get it. Dang! Woo! I don't know if you guys know what this is, but this is the Enki NTO3 Plus M. This wheel spec is an 18 by 10.5, 5 by 114. So it's a pretty big boy. One of my dream wheels right here. Let's see how heavy it is. Ooh, I don't want to scratch that. Don't mind this. Let's see how good this thing is. Dang. Look how wide this wheel is. Woo! Alright, let's see what else we got. This came in the package. I believe this might be the center caps, but I'm not too sure. Let's see what it is. Okay. All right, this is the center caps. Enki. You can see that it says performance Enki. Pretty nice, comes with the screws and Allen key. So yeah, last but not least, the tire setup. This is a Federal 595, 265/35/18. These are gonna be a little stretched on the new wheel setup. I just like the stretch look better, but yeah, my goal is slammed, but we'll see how well these tires hold up. So I'll let you guys know. So yeah, we're gonna do one last cinematic look at the new wheels, and here you go. Here's the Evo. It's under a cover right now. It's been raining the past couple days, so we're gonna take off the cover. Let me do a little walk around for you guys. Interior check. This is the interior of my car. It's kind of dirty at the moment, but yep, that's the interior. That's how the back seat looks like. Carbon Kevlar. Bride seats with Takata harnesses. In the rear, we have VLAN tails, carbon diffuser, NVIDIA single exit exhaust. We got password JDM gurney flap, carbon fiber. You know, just a couple of exterior mods, but it's something that I like, so. But yeah, that's just a little bit about my car. We're gonna go get the tires mounted in a bit here, so catch you guys in a second. All right, we got the tires and wheels in the back loaded up. Time to get them mounted. Just finished mounting all the tires on the new wheels. Time to head home. Shout out to my boy Two with the clean Subi for hooking me up. Tires are all mounted, looking good. All right, it's a couple days later.
We just got done jacking up the car. As you can see, it's off the ground. But we're gonna test fit the wheels and see how they look. I'm gonna fix another issue I have, which is when I unlock the car, this light is dead, so we're gonna see if we can try to fix it. All right, as you guys can see, I got most of the bumper parts off. Let's see if we can take this off. See, we got the wheels outside, about to mount them on the car. All right guys, before I do mount the wheels though, I did pick up some cheap, you know, AutoZone lug nuts, but these are just temporary until my lug set come on Friday, so this will have to do. Aggressive than my liking. I like it a little more flush than this. It's pretty meaty, so I'm gonna see if I can put the 15 mil spacers on instead. I did pick up a set of thin wall impact sockets from Menards, so hopefully these do not scratch up the new wheels, because they do have a plastic liner on the outside that help protect the wheel from getting scratched. Here's how the sockets look like. We will be using the 17 mil today to install these new lug nuts. We're gonna install the wheels without spacers. We just took them off right there, so. Wow, guys. You can see fitment is like mint. Like, I don't know how else to say, you know? But whoever told me these need 15 mil spacers, you a damn liar. All right, we're putting the first wheel on without spacers. I am getting hub centric rings soon in the mail, because the ones I bought, they did not fit. So I'm just gonna try the wheels right now without hub rings, see how well they do. Hopefully they don't vibrate that bad. Jiggle it. Well, as you guys saw, the fitment was great, but on the inside, the tire was touching the coilover, so we are going to have to run the 15 mil and see how good the fitment is now instead. So I'm gonna show you guys how to install it. Guys, we're gonna install the wheel again with the 15 mil spacer. What you guys are seeing is me struggling to put on the wheel due to the fact that the 15 mil spacer is hitting the back of the wheel. And in order for you to run this spacer, you will need to shave down the back of your studs, which I didn't want to do. So instead, I swapped the 15 to a 10 millimeter in order to run this wheel. Alright guys, day 3 of fixing the Evo 10. So what we did update was we maxed out the negative camber on the plates. We recently picked up some cheap advanced auto spacers. These are about 8 millimeter. Now the wheel fitment is money. We test fitted them on the rears earlier. This is how it looks like with the
negative camber maxed out. And on this side, this is how it looks like with zero camber. But overall, I really like the look of the driver's side, so we're gonna do the same thing on this side. All right, now that we got the bolts loose, we're gonna attempt to push it inward so we could get the negative camber. All the way in. Guys, we just put the wheel on. As you can see, this is how the fitment looks like now. Almost perfect. The wheel is turned a little bit that way right now, so don't mind that. But other than that, it's near perfect. That's how it would look like on the ground. We just mounted all four wheels. What do you guys think? With or without mud flaps? Honestly, I think the without looks better right now because of how meaty it is, but it's just my opinion. All right, we finally finished putting the wheels on the car. This is how low it sits down. I'll show you guys the fitment. Fitment is on point. All around is plus 8. We'll need to raise the front about 1/2 inch to match the rears. This is how the car looked like after the install. As you guys can see, the wheel fitment was perfect, but I did have to raise the car up due to the fact that it was rubbing pretty hard on the fenders. So this is how it looked like after. This is how the car currently sits as of today. I'm currently running a 10 mil spacer in the front due to rubbing on the suspension and the caliper. After resolving this issue, the car runs phenomenal and runs even better than it did before. If you've gotten this far in the video, I just want to say I appreciate you for watching, and I'll catch you next time. Thank you.